You're not Morgan Fairchild.
Excuse me?
Heaven. I always imagined Morgan Fairchild.
I'm Dr. Markman, and you're not dead. But you will be soon if you don't stop drinking.
You got anything for the pain?
You have liver damage, esophageal varices, immune system dysfunction, likely renal failure. Frankly, it'd be faster to tell you what you don't have.
Maybe the online medical school you graduated from didn't cover this before they emailed you your diploma. I'm gonna try to make this simple. The technical term is withdrawal.
You need to stop drinking.
Spare me the sermon.
Juan will take you to processing.
Processing?
You're being released.
What?
If we keep you here, we'd have to treat you. Stop drinking before it kills you.
Give us a minute, Mac, will you? Siegel stepped in it now, didn't he?
I like that, Mr. Dragna. Siegel's boys been puffed up too long. I'd like to wipe that swagger off their face.
We keep our guys in line. Make sure they stay on task.
Ladies and gents, I invite you to patronize another fine gambling house right here in Hollywoodland. My associate there will be passing out business cards. Your chips will happily be accepted there while this establishment is closed for renovations. Boys, start renovating.
Everybody stop! Ace!
Hold it, hold it. Stacks, what are you doing here?
I work with these people, you?
Well, same thing.
You got a sec?
Stand by.
Your boss, Dragna's making a big move, I hear.
Sure, with your man Bugsy in the slam, it's a green light.
Like this, really?
It's what Dragna wants.
Will you take some advice?
You're not in charge here.
Of course not. I've surrendered. Still, the advice is free. You're scaring the hell out of these people. What good is that? They're not gangsters. Look at them. They're a bunch of dentists. You think they're gonna stroll up the street and give you their business after you scared them half to death pointing guns at them?
You make sense.
Point them at me. I work for Siegel.
Nothing to worry about here. Just let these gentlemen do what they came here to do. What they're not gonna do is hurt anybody.
That's right. Except him. Anybody tries anything, Siegel's boy gets it. You guys on a break? Keep at it. Sorry to bother you, ma'am, but a young woman had an accident last night just outside. She had no identification on her.
Oh, my God. What happened?
Well, it appears she jumped off the roof.
Oh, my God. Oh, my God. I wonder if it was Carol.
Carol?
Yeah, my friend. She went up there last night.
What's Carol's last name?
Lewis. Found out her boyfriend was cheating on her.
And you were?
I'm sorry. I was just sleeping. This is really hard.
Could I see some ID, ma'am?
I'm Alice.
If I could still see some ID.
Yeah, of course.
Did she leave anything here?
No.
Was she drinking?
We had some wine.
How much?
A bottle between the two of us.
Drugs? Did you go up on the roof with her?
Because they call me the wet.
No, she wanted to be alone. She said that she wanted to be alone.
And you said she was upset. Was she crying?
Yes.
Hard?
Yeah.
And you still let her go up on the roof by herself.
I didn't know that she was that upset.
But she was crying. Hard.
Carol used to cry a lot. Vince would say something or do something that would hurt her feelings, and last night I was really tired, and I guess I didn't know what to do for her.
Vince is the boyfriend?
Yes.
Was he abusive?
Oh, no, it wasn't like that. He's a really good guy.
Except for the cheating.
Yeah.
There you go. Thanks.
I can't believe Carol would kill herself.
Actually, she's not dead, but she's pretty busted up. This information will be very useful in identifying her. She isn't able to talk. Visual ID is highly unlikely considering the state she's in. Dental records are useless, and we can't get prints off her until after she's out of critical, and who knows how long that's gonna be.
I'm suddenly not feeling so well. I think I need to lay down.
Understandable. Someone will be in touch with you if we need more information.
Thanks.
Yep. Dispatch, Lieutenant Warner, possible ID on jump victim on 23 Stilson.
Of course I am.
Good news, bad news.
You know I like my dessert first.
Backchecked the rail line like you asked, found a couple of spots where they unloaded the cars. One set of tracks headed west until it hit the main highway and disappeared. But another set of tracks headed east. 107-inch wheelbase, 8.5-inch tread.
The GT40 that was missing from the manifest.
Followed the trail a couple of miles, pretty easy in this scrub. Can't move without leaving sign.
Give me the damn veggies.
The ground rolls into a hard pack and we lost that track too.
Let's find ourselves a car. We got a hit! 70s Charger! We gotta move on!
Stopped about a block ahead.
Park it, we're going on foot.
The Toretto! You're under arrest.
I don't feel like I'm under arrest.
You turn around and put your hands behind your back.
I don't think so.
Your mistake is thinking you've got a goddamn choice, boy.
Your mistake? Thinking you're in America. This is Brazil!
Come on, boss, another day. Come on, age, it's a lot of heat.
I'll see you soon, Toretto. Dagger step, cover me!
I need copies of the statement accounts for the last three. Yes, Ald.
Great.
Yeah.
I just wanted to tell you how sorry I am.
Thank you.
You know, a similar thing happened to a friend of my cousin's. Young guy, skiing. Some kid on a snowboard comes up, totally out of control. Bam. Snowboard, severed his jugular. Blood all over the slope. And then, you know, people started to ski over it, so it spread down the hill and...
Judge asks you, you tell him what you told us and identify Darlene in court. The minute I get your statement in, with you sitting right there, the public defender's gonna wet his pants and fold. I'll make a deal in 5 minutes, get this guy in jail today. Easy peasy.
Deal? Wait. Hang on, what do you mean? What deal? I want this guy to go away for the rest of his life.
Mr. Hume, I've got one eyewitness, you. That's nice. But do you know how many cases with one witness I don't even bother to try for a deal on? We've just got your word. That's not bad if I can scare the guy into a deal.
You're using my son's death like some kind of card trick.
Look, I get a banger off the street. A year or so, somebody does my job for me. He doesn't get out of there alive. fine with me. He finds Jesus, fine with me. But we get religion and go to trial, as much as I'd love to, and the defense starts working on, when was your last eye exam, and what do you have against inner city youth, and how unfair it is for them to grow up so violent, how they're forced into initiation killings or face execution themselves. You want a jury feeling sorry for this fucker, huh? This is a take it or leave it thing.
Gate secured. FBI, ma'am, Jersey field office.
Mind if I see your ID?
Not at all.
My dad's a cop. Force of habit.
Your father sounds like a very smart man.
This bitch is a handful.
Are you gonna be all right? You really are his daughter. Tie her wrists.
Don't move! You! Get away from the bag! Now!
Okay, okay.
We've been waiting for you.
Yeah. We're waiting for you, too.
Girlfriend, dickhead. Hold on a minute. Looks like he's coming around.
It's the guy who's on the dark floor. The kid is...
Get all that? That's right.
I'm on the third floor, but I'm coming to get you. Don't move now. I'll send a doctor.